Exactement.
Hello everybody. So we are from Le Redouné Uzès. I'm Rachel Tech. This is Michel. And Frédéric Ajalrag is shooting as usual. We are visiting at Le Port Camargue the Panin family. So we have Sian, Jérôme, Eoline, and Astrid. And they are ready to leave for a 4-year trip around the world. So we are here to visit the boat and ask them questions.
Hello, my name is Josephine.
I'm Victoria.
Hello, my name is Mathilda.
What's your name?
My name is Astrid.
And me, it's Jérôme.
My name is Eoline.
My name is Sian.
And family name?
Panin. Everybody.
Have you got pets?
We had pets, but now we gave them because we can't keep them on the boat.
What's your job?
My job is photograph information and other things, but it's not important for the moment. Jérôme?
And my job is skipper. And sometimes, skipper.
He's also a hydrogeolog.
Oh, okay. And where do you live?
At the moment, we used to live in Bouillargues. It's a small village near Nîmes, but now we are going to live on the boat.
Where do you come from?
I come from Savoie, from the mountains, and I met my husband on the sea in the Caribbean. Oh. He was my teacher, right?
Oh. Et vas-y,
and I'm.
Where are you from?
I come from Nîmes. It's not very fast. Very, very far. And.
Eoline, where are you born? Where are you born?
I was born in.
In Sian?
I was born in
Savoie. Where? The country, the city. Belay?
Okay.
Thank you.
When have you got your first boat?
My first boat is a monorail, you know? It's a monorail, it's a simply sailing boat, and in aluminium.
It was 11 years ago, before we had the cheese. No, 15 years.
Yeah.
We had it 4 years. We were in we had a school school cruise in the Caribs, and then we get back to have the two children, and now we get another boat for around the world.
Hello, I'm Emma.
My name is Pauline.
I'm Julie.
My name is Iris.
When did you travel for the last time?
Yesterday. No, we traveled about 12 years ago, because we had no children, and then we had children, so we stopped to prepare this this voyage.
What's the country did you visit before?
Which country?
What's the country did you visit before?
Before? Egypt, Caribbean, Brazil,
Venezuela,
Greece, Tunisia.
And all this by boat?
Venezuela,
Guyana,
Cuba, In Australia.
In Australia, of course, but Australia not by boat. Yeah. Australia with the children. We change house with Australian people. They came to Rissan. Maybe you knew them. They had two children like us, and we went in their house in Australia, 6 months.
Okay. What is your favorite country?
All over the world.
France?
She doesn't know. No, yet, maybe. Where do you would you like to go?
Brazil.
Brazil. And you?
Brazil. What is your best memory? Where was it?
I'm afraid you don't
What is your best memory? Where was it?
I couldn't say because everywhere there is something strong and nice and people very nice. But the best for me, it's Salvador de Bahia, the carnival. It's just huge.
I know.
I must to talk about your meeting in Cali.
But which island was it in the Caribbean?
Guadeloupe.
Guadeloupe. He was a sailing teacher in Guadeloupe. Hmm.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Manu.
My name is Valentin.
Hi, I'm Kellyanne.
What is your itinerary?
The itinerary is on the site. There is a hearth and you can see everything. I don't know if we can show or if it's better to tell.
No, perhaps you can tell first.
Okay.
Je
connais mieux la destination que moi, mais bon. Donc on.
In first Maroc. And after Canaria. Capo Verde. And after you across Atlantic and after Brazil, Guyana, Trinidad and Tobago, Venezuela. It's a long list. Venezuela, Panama. You know Panama? You see too?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
And after in Pacific Ocean, Galapagos, Polynesia, French Polynesia, and Marquise before, French Polynesia after, and after simply Vuamotu, Tuamotu, the New Guinea,
Papouasie,
Indonesia, Sri Lanka, Seychelles, Madagascar, et South Africa, Tanzania, South Africa, after maybe Brazil. Second time and
three times
February.
Every February.
And we'll return in
France.
Maybe.
So thank you for your question.
Wrong answer.
What are the main cities that you go visiting?
All. It's the same as we said before, it will be the capitals and then we go inside the country. Like Brazil, we are going in Amazonia. Above all, we want to go on the rivers. Like Amazonia, we go by boat along the river to see the
tribes.
Yeah. To see tribes very far in the country. about your project on water. Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly.
That's why, yes, because we can go in city, a village where we can't go by plane or by a boat or by a car. You just can go by the rivers. That's why we want to do that on the water, because it's the best way to go in the village.
And when you said Guyana, was it French Guyana or Guyana?
Yes, French Guyana.
Because I went to Mariposa? What? Yes.
Yeah, but
so this is the end of the... Maripasula. This is the end of the world, really.
Yes. But it's close to the Suriname. Yes.
But with this boat, it's impossible to go to
I know some teachers who goes at school by pirogue.
Yes, completely lost.
In Venezuela, we had children who went to school by pirogues, because there are different villages in small islands, and there are the main islands, and all the children go by...
How long is the longest non-stop crossing?
3 weeks. 3 weeks.
3 weeks without seeing the earth. Just water.
Day and night.
It's a long line. That's why we have these big boats, because we can live completely autonomous.
Thank you.
Your last question was just excellent.
Hello, I am Joyce.
Hello, my name is Clément.
Hello,
I am. Hello, I am. Is that your trip? Is a humanitarian trip?
No, exactly.
No, exactly. It's more in the environmental trip, and also humanitarian, but the first it's environmental.
For what the chapel?
Pour quelle raison c'est environnemental? Dans quel but
Tu peux le vocabulaire. Je peux répondre en français. Mais...
La réponse en français déjà, et puis après on peut... tu parles aussi.
Pourquoi alors c'est la question, c'est pourquoi c'est environnemental, c'est ça? Parce que le projet au fil de l'eau, c'est donc de voir comment dans chaque pays, de manière intrinsèque, individuellement, chaque pays est concerné par le problème de la potabilité de l'eau, enfin, de l'eau dans tous ses états, de toute façon. Et voir quelles solutions sont apportées, voir aussi les conséquences qu'il peut y avoir. Et donc rapporter tout ça à travers un site et auprès de vous, par exemple, en priorité, et puis par ricochet d'autres personnes. Et parce qu'en France, on est peu sensible à ce genre de problème, par les jeux, on est un peu menti au niveau de l'eau, surtout aujourd'hui. Et parce que la France va être encore un des derniers bastions où on va avoir de l'eau potable. Même malgré tout ce qu'on peut dire à la radio, même si nous, à partir du moment où nous, on manque un peu d'eau potable, il faut prendre conscience que dans plusieurs pays, des dizaines de pays, ils en souffrent terriblement. Puisque nous, on est en dernière phase. Donc plutôt on prend les choses en amont, plutôt on peut prévenir des conséquences qui sont dramatiques. Parce qu'on peut se passer du pétrole, plus ou moins. Mais de l'eau, on ne peut pas.
C'est la vie.
On en a.
Malo.
Alors, in which country you go to do humanitarian project?
In fact, we have answered when we say the itinerary.
There is no humanitarian.
See, it's perhaps something humanitarian, because we relate what happened in different countries.
Speak about the school in Senegal, perhaps?
Yes, yes, because we'd like to give contact between French school and foreign schools. So it's to show how it is other where in the world. how the people live, and to show that children over there can also give us something. Not only we are there to help them with rice or other things, but themselves they can give us something also, and that's important to tell.
Is that your trip will also have a scientific purpose?
Yes, a small scientific purpose, because we are going to see how is the water and make some experience, but it's not the only purpose. But it's just to sensibilize people overall.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Lauren.
My name is François.
I'm Laurie.
We are going to speak Everyday Life Organization. Question one, how do you get electricity?
We get electricity by éolien.
Éolien
and photovoltaïque cellule. Panel, solar panel, and motor, generator.
And it's on batteries, and then the batteries give electricity.
How can you connect to the satellite?
Yes, we hope to connect the satellite by a system in Marsa.
Behind.
How can you call the rescues if you are the problem?
Fusée de détresse.
Il doit y avoir un terme technique, mais
il y a une borne aussi. Comment ça s'appelle? On lance dans l'eau et qui donne le repère.
Oui,
je sais pas, alarme roquette ou quelque chose comme ça.
Oui.
Cospas, message with the bouquet of the boat and the name of the boat.
Okay. How and what do you eat?
We make provision before going. We buy everything and we have about 5-6 caddies. And then we use every day what we have got. We put all the water is here. For example, you see, there are reserves everywhere in the boat, like that. You can put the bottle for the fresh water, and after we have the tank, and sometimes we fish also. We have big fish, strong fish, and we can eat fishes and stuff like that.
And how do you get drinking water?
We have a reserve, and also it exists a desalinizer to change the sea water in fresh water. It's a special engine.
But it's too expensive.
It's very expensive and very complicated. It's easier to have this, but you can use also this way of.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Sarah.
Hello, I'm Fanny.
Hello, I'm Mario.
Hello, my name is Harry.
What are your classes?
I'm classes in...
Fifth. Yes, but you know, cinquième is very French, so you can say cinquième.
Okay.
Because fifth is... Yeah. It's just French.
Yeah.
Cinquième.
And you?
Sixième. C'est pas de phrase.
How will be your teacher during your trip? How will be your teacher during your trip?
In fact, the study with the books like that. Everything is in the book, and the exercise is also inside. And you have this for correction. And every 3 weeks there are evaluations, and we send them to the kid.
A little bit before summer.
How many will you
work? Will you work?
Four hours.
And you? No, not really. For you, it's 2 hours.
Every day.
She was very quickly. I don't know how it will be at the end.
And every day, even Sunday and Saturday?
No, not Sunday. They have a day rest. But normally it's every day. If everything is done on the Friday, it's okay. Otherwise, they work also the
Saturday. En français, parce qu'il faut, savoir que des fois, il y a des modulations dures. C'est-à-dire que le temps ne permet pas d'avoir du confort. On ne peut pas étudier normalement.
Donc, c'est tout avec des CD.
On le fait le dimanche. Quand on est, quand le temps le permet, on essaie de prendre de l'avance pour toujours, comme ça, avoir du temps pour ne pas étudier. C'est-à-dire que des fois, s'il y a force vide, par exemple, les vagues qui submergent ici, donc à ce moment-là,
Et aussi, si on va visiter des choses, si on part visiter quelque chose, on va partir 2 jours, elles ne vont pas emmener leurs devoirs. Donc pendant ce temps-là, elles ne font pas de devoirs. Et puis elle le prend plus concentré sur deux autres jours. Là en ce moment, elle travaille le matin, mais tous les après-midi, elle fait autre chose. Elle va plager, elle va faire autre chose.
Donc là, ils ont pris un peu d'avance pour qu'au moment de partir, on puisse avoir quelque chose.